What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my Side LP series. This is Side LP number 4, and I'm playing NBA Jam. And this is the remake of the old NBA Jam. You might have played it in the arcades, or as I played it, on the Super Nintendo Entertainment System, or the Super NES. And this is a remade game with updated rosters, updated logos, and a couple of cool game modes. So you got the regular playthrough, you got your exhibition games. I played a couple games with my friends. You can play over Xbox Live, which is pretty sweet. You got jam challenges, which is pretty much things you do throughout the game. And they unlock certain things, like this unlocks the USA ball. Open options, blah blah blah. Classic campaign, you pretty much pick a team and then go up against all the other teams. And after, I believe, 6 games, you go and face like a boss, which I think is like an all-star team. And then you got Remix Tour, you have to unlock section by section. I'm not quite sure what you have to do. I'm guessing you just play games, like, because it's NBA Jam. Remix Modes, I'm not quite sure what that is. Boss Battles, like I said, I think you unlock them through the campaign. High Scores is pretty much records your highest scores individually per player, per game. And then Jam Camp, I'm not quite sure what that is. But we're going to do Classic Campaign. And I've played like 5 games already, so I'm right at the end of the first section. As you can see, my games are, I played 4 games. As you can see, I've gotten a little bit better as I've gone along. First couple games were close, and I've blown up the last 2 opponents. But I'm going to be playing the Milwaukee Bucks, which is kind of appropriate since I'm from Wisconsin. And I'll be playing them with my favorite team, the Dallas Mavericks, who won the title, oh, just 1 year ago. But now we're now and playing NBA Jam, so it's pretty sweet. It's pretty sweet. So you'll see what happens with the NBA Jam if you've never played it. So here is the tip-off here in Milwaukee, and I got Dirk Nowitzki and Caron Butler. I chose Dirk Nowitzki and Caron Butler because Dirk Nowitzki is the man, and secondly, Caron Butler is a little bit more physical than Jason Kidd. Oh snap! That was fucking sweet. Caron goes up for the dunk, and I get the alley-oop along with it. Oh, I figured he was going to get blocked there. He got the rebound, though. That's nice. Alley-oop! There goes the alley, and here comes the oop. Yeah. A little semi-pro line there for you. I want to get on fire right away here. No. Come on, come on, come on. Give me the ball. Fire! Fuck you! Oh, that was sweet. So, let me explain a little bit about the game here. As you can see, you can do crazy shit. Dunk and alley-oop and such like that. You can get on fire, you make 3 shots in a row, and you're pretty much almost impossible to miss, but apparently I did right there. So, and apparently you can't make the shot when you're on fire. Normally you're on fire, you can't fucking miss. That's why you're on fire. But apparently this game don't like me. But Milwaukee's got Andrew Bogut and Brandon Jennings. Funny enough, I think I saw Brandon Jennings Andrew Bogut's last college game. He played with Utah before he was the first overall pick by Milwaukee. And they played in the NCAA tournament in Milwaukee. I think it was 2003-2004. I'm not quite sure what year it was. But they were up against Boston College, I think. And they lost the first round, but I believe that was his last game in college. And actually, the other teams that were there, Wisconsin was actually playing in Milwaukee that year, which was pretty sweet. And Georgia Tech was playing in Milwaukee, and they went to the finals, but they lost. That was when they had B.J. Elder and Jarrett Jack. But let's get back to this game. So basically, you get sprint, which makes you faster, of course. That's usually what sprint does. Banked it. Knew it. 3. And you can do crazy stuff like jumping and alley-oops and dunks, and you can even shatter the backboard. I've not done that yet. An opponent did that to me. My first game against Minnesota did that to me. I was a little pissed off. Oof. I knew I was going to get blocked there if I didn't pass, but he knocked down the pass anyway. Here we go. Oh! Alley-oop, baby. So, I might do Jason Kidd in the second half just so you get both of the Mavericks. Oh, that was sweet. like those really good dunkers in this game, because all the stats are based off of just points up to, I don't think they go past 9. They might go past 9. I think they might go up to 10. Like, somebody really good at something gets 10. Fuck, that was awful. But I've been playing long enough here where I shouldn't be challenged at all. I'm playing on normal difficulty. So, it was actually pretty hard the first couple of games, but now I've gotten sort of used to the game, and it's not too much of a challenge now. But damn, I was on fire to start the game. I can't believe it didn't. I can't believe he missed both those shots on fire. That was such crap. Oh, Butler's almost on fire now. He gets one more basket, he gets to go on fire. But Milwaukee. Oh, I also kind of I tried to record this a couple of games. I tried to record during the New York game, and that didn't quite work out. But I figure this is a good spot to do it because I'm right at the end of this sequence of teams, and I figure I can show you guys whatever's at the end of this. Like I said, it's probably like a mini-boss sort of type thing. I'm not quite sure what it is even, so Dirk's gonna get down here, pass it, alley-oop, 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 boom! God damn it, I love that. Now, you can see the coaches there in the background. That does not look anything like Rick Carlisle, though. It looks like George Karl over there. He wasn't the Bucks coach then. Oh, fuck, that hurt. And he's playing head games with fuck, his oh, he got us the pump fake. That's pretty nice. Butler. Ooh, Butler, sweet use of the backboard there. Yeah, mainly I try and just like steal and then. Oh, that was nice. Alley-oop, alley-oop, alley-oop. Oh, it didn't quite work out. You can see that. I slam it home after he's already dunked it. Nice. Alley-oop. Oh, you see that behind the back alley-oop pass there? Damn it. I'm up 7. I'm up 19 right now. Just gonna keep going. I jumped ahead a little bit in this game just so that I can get the whole thing and it'd be short enough here. I put Jason Kidd in just so that you can see the other Dallas Maverick. And you can see right there why I like Caron Butler more is because Jason Kidd doesn't really have any blocking stat at all. Oof. And Butler's a lot more physical, so you can actually block somebody. But I figured I was up 17 at half. I figured I could switch him out without losing. Because Jason Kidd's stats are high in like stealing and passing, which isn't very useful in NBA Jam because anybody could pass or steal. I mean, it's not really a skill that needs to be high in order to be good. Fuck, I knew I was going to get blocked there. Come on, block him. That sucks. All right, come on, come on, come on. Let's get a dunk in here or something, kid. Let's do an alley-oop. That's God damn it. Come on, you're supposed to be good at handling. A fucking Bogut's on fire. Great. God damn it. Fuck you. Jesus Christ. No. Fuck you. Let's go. Give me the ball. God damn it. Come on, come on, come on. Trash. Blocked. Fuck you. Here comes a dunk. There goes your fire. Jesus. Not doing so hot here in the third quarter, but I mean, sometimes it gets difficult. Damn. All right, 4 seconds left. I can get a shot off. Oh! I needed to do that. I needed to do the little crossover move there just so that I could get enough separation where it wouldn't block it. Come on, block it, kid. There you go. Doing something right. Jumped ahead again just so that same thing again. Just have enough time to do everything here. Nice block. Game's gotten a little bit closer here in the fourth, but I'm controlling it enough. Oh, okay. No alley-oop. Just a dunk. So I'm back up 10 now here, so that's good. Hopefully I can keep this lead and not have to worry. Come on, kid. Block. Nice. There we go. Alley-oop, alley-oop, alley-oop. Oh, shit. I'm on fire. That was pretty. So let's stop him here. Nope. fuck. That was so awesome. Ah, damn, there goes the fire. So I'm still up 12, though.
1 minute remains in the fourth quarter. Passes.
Oh, that would have been... Oh, that's a three. That would have been sweet if Dirk would have caught that in midair. They can do that in this game. You can catch a shot in midair and dunk it. That would have been sweet. Jennings hits a three, though. No, he missed it. Dirk can't quite block it, but that's a three? I thought his foot was on the line. In all honesty. Oof. Get it off, get it off. Fuck. No. No, 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 no. Bogey, you're not doing that. Dirk will not allow it. Alley-oop. Oh, I thought I was going to alley-oop there. Didn't quite get it. 8 seconds. Nice. And I'm going to win this game pretty easily. Block to finish it off. Don't bring that Kool-Aid to a grown man's party, Brandon Jennings. Do not do that. So I go on a 5-game winning streak in Classic Campaign, and I get a challenge, NBA challenge thing. So now we are going to find out what this Legends Battle, so that's what this end thing is. Let's get started here with the Legends Battle. I'm just going to start the game off, and it's going to be the New York Knicks Legends. Alright, Ewing and Starks, John Starks and Patrick Ewing. Yeah, I know who they are. I ain't that young. John Starks and Reggie Miller had a bit of a feud in the 90s, early 90s. Mid-90s too, I guess. Tonight's matchup. But we are back in New York, and I'll play the first quarter here of this for you guys. Oh, and I lose the tip. Nice. Alley-oop to start. Patrick, I don't think so. And I'm getting a quick start against these legends. Oh no, you dropped something, Starks. How about an alley-oop for you? Oh no, Butler's just gonna slam it home. So that's what this game is. Ah, fuck, I lost it there. Damn it, Butler was so close to having the on fire. I'm gonna go an alley-oop again. They don't know what's going on. But that little hiccup in my recording stuff, all I missed was an alley-oop by me. Oh shit, they got an alley-oop now. Pretty sweet. But I did say, after it crapped out, that I think the NBA Legends for the teams are the original people that were on the original NBA Jams for each of these teams. I'm pretty sure Patrick Ewing and John Starks would have been both on the original NBA Jam. Ah, crap, crap, crap. Nice block. Come on. Let's go. Alley-oop! Oh my god, what was that? That was fucking awful. No! That's right, grab it. Nope. Oh, you see that? He fucking looked at the camera, stuck his tongue out, and... Oh, that was awesome. That was funny as hell. No way, Ewing. No way, Ewing. Come on, grab it, grab it, grab it! I was gonna say, he's not gonna get that shot off there. Alright, up 14-8 here. I wanna be up going into the second quarter here. Oh, sweet alley-oop. So only 38 seconds left. Come on, come on, come on. No, 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 no. Nice block. Oh, that was way off. Ewing got the ball back though. I push him. Starks, no, 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 no. Fuck. Alright. I gotta do something here. Don't push. Come on, violence is never the answer. Oh, that was not goaltending. Well, it looks like that will do it for today, fellas and ladies. So I'm going to continue playing this game, but I hope you enjoyed this Side LP, and there'll be more to come into the future. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys next time.